Hello everyone, Brennan McCauley here with the Theology of the Body Institute. I'm just gonna say I'm excited for this video because today we're gonna dive in to the goodness and truth of authentic womanhood, motherhood. Yes, there are many similarities we see between men and women, but there are many differences. And in this video, we're gonna focus on the uniqueness and truth of femininity. I want to start out by reading you this quote by Archbishop Fulton Sheen because it's incredible. He says this, "When a man loves a woman, he has to become worthy of her. The higher her virtue, the more noble her character, the more devoted she is to truth, justice, goodness, the more a man has to aspire to be worthy of her." And then he says this, "The history of civilization could actually be written in terms of the level of its women." Okay, what power lies within woman that Fulton Sheen says the history of civilization could actually be written in terms of the level of its women? Well, that's what we're gonna get into today. I don't think it's a coincidence that we see all throughout history, we see it very clearly in the art forms, in music, and in movies, that the man is the one who always goes out, seeks, tries to win the heart of the woman. We see this in the movie Say Anything. The woman's in her room and the guy's outside next to his car holding up a boombox trying to serenade the woman and win her heart. We see this in other movies where the woman is trapped in a castle and the man goes to rescue her. I've never seen a movie, to my knowledge, where the man is trapped in a castle and the woman goes to rescue him. And I'm not saying it can't happen, but I think these depictions are saying something about the difference between men and women and also the power that lies within woman. What do we see in the book of Genesis? We see that the woman, I'm just gonna say very clearly, is the most beautiful in all creation. She's God's final masterpiece, the grand finale of creation. And John Paul II says, "When Adam saw Eve in the beginning, he had a deep sense of wonder and admiration, or even better, a sense of fascination towards the mystery of her femininity." We see in the book of the Song of Songs, which is a poem in the Old Testament describing a bridegroom and a bride. And to paraphrase John Paul II, he says, "The Song of Songs is like a window into Eden before original sin." And we read this beautiful line in the Song of Songs that the bridegroom says to the bride. He says, "You are a garden enclosed. You are a fountain sealed." I think he's basically saying, normal language can't describe how beautiful you are. I need to use poetry. You're a garden and you're enclosed. You're sealed. Why? Well, John Paul II says it's because the woman is the master of her own mystery. The man can't just barge in to her garden, to her inmost heart. The man must recognize the dignity and gift that woman is. And the woman must only open her body, her garden, her inmost heart to the man who will love her forever, who will lay his life down for her and care for her. And when she does open to the man who will do that, the woman has the capacity to receive the seed of a man, to cultivate life and transform life within her, and then to give it forth and bear it forth. And then she has the capacity to nurture her child at her breast. I'm just gonna say this, men can't do this. This is what's unique about womanhood. And I think it sings something about femininity. It's beautiful, it's good. You know, the world says sometimes that motherhood is a burden. No, it is good, it is a gift. And this is what John Paul II says about these dynamics of generation between a man and a woman and the fact that the woman is the one who cultivates life within her, whereas the man doesn't. This is what John Paul II says, and I think this is for men to listen up. He says, "Parenthood is realized more fully in the woman, especially before birth. It is the woman who pays directly for this shared generation, which literally absorbs the energies of her body and soul. It is necessary that the man be fully aware. He owes a special debt to the woman." Absolutely. I think men need to recognize this. He owes a special debt because the woman absorbs the energies of her body and soul when she's cultivating this life within her. The man must protect and guard this. And so the two great qualities that we see that lies within femininity, within womanhood, the first is the capacity to be receptive. We see this expressed through the woman's body. And here's a little lesson. The Hebrew word in Genesis for female is nekeva, which means to be pierced or opened. And so we see this capacity within the feminine genius to be receptive. And we see this call of every woman, the maturation of every woman is motherhood. Some are called to be mothers in the physical sense, but all women are meant to become mothers in the spiritual sense. And so I'd like to conclude with a final story about this one mother. It's not a story about Mother Mary, and she, Mother Mary, is the model of all womanhood. But I want to share a story about this other woman named Blessed Chiara Corbella, who died in 2012, and she was from Italy. Chiara got married at 24 years old and was soon after pregnant with a baby girl. But throughout her pregnancy and certain tests, she found out that this baby would not survive long out of the womb. And so doctors and friends were saying, you know, you should consider abortion. And Chiara said, no, this child, my child may not be fit for this life, but is absolutely fit for the next life. We are going to carry our child to the Father in heaven. The baby was baptized. The baby was born, baptized, and they carried her to the Father in heaven. Soon after, Chiara was pregnant again with a baby boy. Sadly, during her pregnancy, she found out that this child as well would not survive long out of the womb. And they're like, Chiara, you should consider abortion. And she said, no, my child may not be fit for this life, but is absolutely fit for the next life. The child was born, baptized, and carried to the Father in heaven. Soon after, Chiara was pregnant a third time with a baby boy, and he was healthy. But Chiara found out that underneath her tongue, she had a tumor. And the doctors were like, Chiara, you need treatment. But this treatment could kill the baby and could it really affect him. And Chiara refused treatment. She said, I'm not going to receive treatment until my baby is born healthy. The baby was born healthy, but Chiara sadly found out her cancer was terminal. And so she went on this journey of suffering with Christ to her death. And I'll never forget her husband, Enrico, the story he told. Right before she died, Enrico and Chiara were praying in the chapel. And the words of Jesus came to Enrico's mind, my yoke is sweet, my burden is light. And he looked over at Chiara and said, Chiara, I don't get it. Is his yoke really sweet? Is the cross you're going through really light? She paused. She looked over at Enrico and smiled and said, yes, Enrico, it is sweet. And she later died a peaceful death. Chiara, who is now Blessed Chiara Corbella, teaches us, is a model of authentic motherhood who gives her life for her children. Blessed Chiara, pray for us. Pray for all mothers and all women. And so I just wanted to conclude with that story. If you've enjoyed this video, I invite you to share it with any of your family or friends. I invite you to subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you soon. God bless.